Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. In this video I will be mostly talking about the post processor extractor. So under post processor extractor we have multiple extractors such as regular expression extractor, boundary extractor, JSON extractor, JMES path extractor, and finally I have GUI post processor extractor as well. So why do we need a post processor extractor? So with the help of a sampler, when we make any request and if we want to extract some of the value from the response body of a particular sample, then with the help of a post processor extractor we can extract the particular value from the sample response. So let me show you about the regex extractor. So under regex extractor, here regular expression extractor, so we also normally call it as regex extractor. So here what I have configured, that apply to, so where to apply, on in the main samples, only in the body section. So I am extracting a response from the body section of a sample. You can also extract the response from the header, or if you want to go for any particular response codes, response messages, as we have multiple codes, 1xx, 2xx, 3xx, 4xx and 5xx. So whatever you want to extract, you can extract from the field. What I am doing, I am trying to find a particular pattern with this help of this regular expression extractor. So I'll be extracting the value which will come it at this particular place. So whatever will be the value, I am looking for it and extracting that particular value and assigning that value to a variable named as regex1. I am also grouping that particular ID, I am grouping as 1. So this is how one can group. So $1, and what is will be the match number. So it's like if in a response file we have multiple IDs, it's like I have 5 to 7 IDs, so which particular ID I need to fetch. So with this help of this match number, I can specify that particular ID which I need to pick. So currently I have used a 0 for random, and finally a default value. What if I could the response file does not contain that particular pattern, the regular expression, then what I will get? So finally, if there is no such pattern, then the default value of the regex1 variable will be set as regex1_error. You can give anything whatever you want. So this is how I can extract a value from a sample. So this is how we will do so. So this is, here I have just shown how to pick a value. But what if we need multiple values? So with the help of regular expression, we can also do that. So here it's like I am also fetching the email ID and the IDs as earlier I was looking for. So here I am selecting for IDs as well as email ID. And again I am grouping it. So it's like, one is for ID and G2 is for email ID. So if we have multiple values, then we can group it. And here also random value 0, what will be the default value kind of error. And finally with the help of debug sampler, we'll be able to find the results. So before going for a results, or let me show you results first, then we'll also talk about the other sampler, other post processor which I am using. So yes, I have started a test. Yes, finally the test ended. Yes. So here is my variables. So regex1. Yes. Here you can see. So this is the response from my first regular expression, this one. So where I was looking for regex1. So this is the output. So regex1 is equal to 10. So here you can see the group ID which I have specified, group is equal to $1. So this is how it specifies a value. And finally the output of the second regular expression is multiple regex, 10 is the ID, and this is brian.fields@regex.in is the email ID. So this is how we can easily pick multiple values as well from a response value. So this is how I have shown about the regex expression. We can also see about the boundary value, boundary extractor, and I feel this is the most easiest one to find anything. So it's like we have to define the left boundary, and after that we have to define the right boundary. So in between these two boundaries, whatever will be the value, we'll be able to fetch it. And I feel we can only fetch a single value with the help of this boundary value extractor at once, because we have to define a left boundary and a right boundary. So with the help of this, we can also, if I can show you here, so this was my request. Again, I think I am, yes, the same request which was there, and I am looking again for a body ID. So anything that will come after ID, so ID is my key, so I am looking for a particular value of the ID. And where is the response data? Yes. So now the boundary says ID extractor is equal to 0. So what is the variable name? Let me check. Okay. So the variable name is boundary, and the value of the boundary is 11. So this is how it got random value, as I have specified in my regex boundary value extractor. Sorry. After that, I have JSON extractor here. So here, with the help of JSON extractor, I'm trying to look for the value of a key named as last name. So with the help of JSON extractor, I'll be trying to find out the last name. And also I'm looking for multiple values from a JSON extractor. So we can also looking for a multiple value at once can be also done with the help of a JSON extractor. And this is how I'm trying to find the ID as well as the email ID from the JSON extractor. Let me show you. So the response data. Yes, so JSON name, the last name was Edward, and when I tried to find for ID and email ID, so ID is 7 and the email ID is michael.lawson@req.in. So this is how one can easily find out about one can easily extract a value from a JSON response. So if anybody wants to have more insight about this JSON extractor, they can easily, I would recommend you to go to this particular website. You can see how we can design the extractor pattern. So we'll have to look, this table will help you to design how I am trying to figure out. So I am looking for a parent operator and then looking for last name or whatever the IDs, the key which I have defined to find the values. So I would request everyone to please visit this page and try to design a extractor pattern with the help of it. So it will be quite helpful. So I will share the link in my description box. After that, finally, we have a JMES path extractor, extractor for a query language for JSON, as I have told earlier as well. So this is how we'll be able to find this. So here, with the response data, I'm trying to find out the last name, and which says, so I'm trying to find out the ID of a person whose last name is Lawson. So this is how you can again, so we'll have to design the expression with the help of which we will be able to find the value. So the, let me show you the results first, then I'll show you how you can also do the same. So the response body, okay, JMES extractor path ID X is equal to 0. So let's, I could not find out the value. So let me show one of the most essential feature. If you fail sometimes, then you can also try to figure out this way. So what is the value? The ID is 7, and what I got in my response, so here JMES path extractor, yes, the value is 7. Sorry, I could not find at that particular time. So this is how you can also test your expression, whether your expression is working fine or not. Finally, we have something, GUI extractor. So if you want to extract something from a GUI, so it's very common in the Selenium, where we mostly deal with a web element, we try to find something or the other from our web application. So this in the similar way we are having, we can also find something or the other from the sample response. So this is a XPath extractor from with the help of which I'm trying to figure out the title, and another extractor is I'm trying to find out the variable whose UL is like unlist attribute. So at the class attribute whose name is nav bar dash nav. So I'm trying to find this CSS selector expression. So let me see the results, then I'll be able to, you'll be, these things are okay. So the title of the page is, so this is the title of the page which I have extracted with the help of XPath extractor. And what about the CSS selector extractor? So this was the navigation bar which says about the page. So it has multiple list. So the list contains home, tutorial, examples, specified specification, libraries and GitHub links. So if you'll see the output here with the help of HTTP here, so I'm finding those results from this sample. If I can show you in some other fashion, yes, the browser. So yes, this was the list which I was trying to find out with the help of the CSS extractor, and the title of the page I think which is not mentioned over here, which I was trying to figure out with the help of a XPath extractor. So this is how you can use all this extractor in your scripts. It's quite helpful when we are designing our scripts. Thank you all for watching my video. Please like and subscribe my channel if video was informative, and also hit the bell icon for more updates. Please feel free to drop suggestions in the comment box as well. And as everyone is familiar with COVID-19 going around, so please stay at home and stay safe.